got you moving, maybe doing a little more improvisation than maybe we've seen in previous weeks?
What was the question exactly?
Do you think with more play action and it allowed you to maybe move a little more and maybe do a little more improvisation?
Yeah, I mean, just play action and kind of boots and nakeds and stuff are something that we've always, you know, thought was kind of one of our bread and butters, especially on first and second down. And getting the run game going really opens up those things. And so gets me on the edge, a chance to make some plays, guys, a chance to make some plays down the field and underneath and everything. So, yeah, I thought we used that effectively tonight.
Carson, the offense had one of the better games of the season. It was good last week against the Giants as well. Do you feel like things are starting to come together for you guys?
I do. I think we're really kind of playing well together, meshing together, kind of doing what we do best, you know, running the ball, kind of relying on those big guys up front from play actions, nakeds, boots, trying to stay on the field on third downs. You know, we got to clean up some things in the red zone for sure. But things are, you know, we left some plays out there, no doubt, but we're kind of starting to kind of mesh a little bit offensively.
You feel like the chemistry is getting a lot better with Golden Tate and getting a feel for him?
Yeah, I mean, every week, every practice, kind of every opportunity with Golden is just an opportunity to just build that relationship, build that chemistry. And tonight he made some great plays. Made some great plays after the catch too, which is big. And it was good to finally get him in the end zone too.
Is that kind of like the role you envisioned for him when you got him, and it kind of took a little while to get there?
Yeah, I think, you know, first and foremost, Golden's a great player. We feel we got a lot of guys offensively that we can spread the ball around too. So we never truly try and focus in on one guy. We're just trying to go after, you know, maybe the weak link in their defense, or just kind of how to let the play come to you. And tonight he was in the right spot and made some great plays, and we'll keep building from there for sure.
Carson, this is like the second week in a row you guys were balanced, like running the ball as well as passing, you know, especially with Josh Adams. Like, how important is that for you guys, you know, as far as winning?
Yeah, I mean, running the football is really our bread and butter. You know, I think it gets those the big boys up front going, kind of gets the defensive line kind of out of pass rush mode, I think. So that's something that's big for us, and just staying balanced and using that, I think, is really our MO for sure.
Happened on the interception in the red zone?
Yeah, I just forced it. I forced it underneath coverage, kind of got there, and just threw it behind him, and Norman made a great play, and I definitely one kind of kicking myself, want to get back.
Carson, just about being in the situation right now where you win, and now you find more life with each win. Just talk about where you are right now as a team, having won and finding that new life again.
Yeah, I mean, it's big for us, especially where we were, now winning two straight and trying to kind of get some momentum going. Doing it against an NFC East opponent was huge, and now kind of setting ourselves up to make a run, you know, to try and do something special here. And I think we're leaving some plays out there, but we're finally starting to click a little bit and mesh together. And, you know, we're extremely excited for next week's opportunity for sure.
In recent weeks, you didn't get sacked today. What's been the difference for the offensive line, and how does that make you feel when you know you're not going to get touched the whole
game? Yeah, again, hats off to the line. You know, they played great football game, both running the ball and protecting me, keeping me upright. You know, it's hard to say exactly what the difference is, but again, I think just as an offensive unit, we're finally starting to kind of mesh and play together. And again, we're leaving plays out there. You know, there's plenty that I'm kicking myself, I want back, but I think the offensive line is really just starting to mesh and play well together.
What is it like having Darren Sproles back, just knowing the journey that he's been through the last 2 years?
Yeah, I mean, having Darren back is awesome. You know, he's a little spark for us offensively. I was extremely stoked to see him get in the end zone. You know, it seems like it's been a while since he's been out there, been a while since him and I got to play together. So having him back in the huddle, having him make some plays the way he did, that definitely gives our offense a little motivation, a little spark, and it was great to see tonight.
Carson, how much does Zach Ertz, the way he runs his routes, the way he's seemingly very predictable, he kind of understands where to be and kind of when to be there, how much easier does it make your job?
Yeah, I mean, it makes my job way easier. You know, having a guy like Zach Ertz, again, you know, it seems like we talk about him all the time, but he just completely understands the game from almost a quarterback's view. Knows where he needs to be, knows coverages, almost knows when I'm going to be hot and when to look early and all sorts of things. So just having another guy with that kind of intelligence, next level intelligence, and then also the way he just runs his routes and gets open. He does a great job, and that's why we keep finding him.
What does it mean to you professionally and personally for him to break the Eagles' all-time single-season record for most catches?
Yeah. That's awesome. You know, I didn't really realize that. At the end of the day, I know he's going to say the same thing. He's just happy we won. But that's good for him, and obviously we've still got a handful of games left.
Seems like you've talked about starting fast for 10 weeks now. What was the benefit of that first drive?
It was huge. I think, you know, it almost kind of got the monkey off your back a little bit, kind of. Like you said, we've talked about it a bunch. We just haven't executed, and this week we did. We made some plays on third down. We got in the end zone there. You know, Golden made a great play getting open on the scramble to finally, you know, seal the drive off. So, again, it kind of just felt like we got that monkey off our back and started the way we wanted to start.
Despite the offense is starting to mesh. How big will that be coming up against an improving Dallas Cowboys defense come next week?
Yeah, I mean, we know Dallas is a great team. They're a great team, a great defense. They make things tough for you. Again, like you said, just the way we're finally starting to mesh a little bit offensively, it's going to be big for us going down there, and we got our work cut out for us for sure.
Despite Ertz's success, there was a report from ESPN yesterday that a team source said that there have been too many targets to him. What do you make of that, and do you feel that there's any validity?
I don't really, you know, think too much into that, honestly. I mean, the guy makes plays. You know, he makes plays. He gets open. I think our effectiveness rate when we do throw his way is pretty successful. So I'm not – if it wasn't, yeah, it would be something we need to evaluate. But, you know, he gets open, plays great football, and he's having a heck of a year.
Carson, tonight I think gives you the second most 300-yard games in franchise history. What does that mean to you? And are you a bit surprised that you've been able to put up those kind of numbers this early in your career?
Yeah, honestly, I don't really know much about the numbers. I know that we left some yards out there. I know I missed a couple. So I really don't think too much about 300-yard games or this or that. All I know is at the end of the day we got a win and we're finally getting some momentum going.
Doug said you felt like the players wanted Sproles to get in the end zone tonight. Was that something you had discussed with him at all throughout the week or even today?
It was nothing we really discussed, but you know we all knew finally getting him back out there. What he kind of brings to the offense, like I said, just a little spark, and he's kind of a quiet leader, and everyone just respects how he works. And man, it was just really good to get him back out there and to get him in the end zone. We were all pretty excited about that.
Sean had a few big catches towards the end of the game. How reliable has he become the last couple of
seasons? Alshon's great. You know, another guy that understands the offense, understands defenses, and plays with, you know, just a sense of urgency and getting open. And just, again, he understands the game, and just having his big kind of physical abilities that he has, big target, great hands. It's a guy that when in doubt, you know, I can look his way too. And, you know, even when he's covered, he's not. So, you know, hats off to him. And, again, we have a lot of guys we can spread the ball out to. So I'm pretty fortunate.
Thanks, guys.